Hey everyone, Steven here from Redolescence and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for tuning into my channel. I really do appreciate it. It means a lot to me. Today I'm very happy to be sharing with you my top 10 favorite fragrances for the winter of 2014 into 2015. I have been wearing these fragrances a lot. I've been looking forward to wearing them a lot, and this season is a testament as to how much I absolutely love these fragrances because the frequency with which I wear them is impeccable during this season. I feel like I can't get my hands off them, so I'm very happy to share this list with you. This is of course going to be the designer version, so if you want to take a look at my niche list, please click the link here and you'll be redirected to that video. But without further ado, let me get into a few of the things that I want to preface this video with. So first thing is, these are my selections. These are fragrances that are in my collection. So there are a lot of really great fragrances out there for the winter season, a lot of which I would love to wear. I just don't have them in my collection, unfortunately. So all of the fragrances in this video are fragrances that I have within my immediate reach, fragrances that I have in my collection. Another thing that I want to mention is that this is a list that I compiled myself. I didn't find this online. A lot of these fragrances you will actually see in my list from last year. So you will see some familiar faces in there. You will also see some new fragrances, some of which have actually been released in 2014, so just last year. I'm very excited that they were able to make this list. And with that being said, you know, let's go ahead and get into the list. I don't want to waste too much time. So we're going to go ahead and start it off with number 10. So my number 10 fragrance is, honestly, it is a favorite of mine. Unfortunately, the reason why it's number 10 and not a little bit higher up on this list is because it has been discontinued, so I'm really trying to be conservative and I'm trying to be frugal in how many sprays I actually wear with this one, because, you know, I dread the day when I actually run out of this bottle because I'm going to be able to only find it online for like a super inflated price. I don't want that to happen, but my number 10 fragrance is Gucci Pour Homme 1 by Gucci. So this is when Tom Ford was the creative director for the company. He does some fantastic things for this company. This is a very woodsy scent. Some people say it smells like pencil shavings, but it's woodsy, vetiver, kind of dirty, but very bold and aggressive and manly. I love this scent. Number 10 on my list. Number 9 on my list is another great fragrance by one of my favorite perfumers, Francis Kurkdjian. I think it's probably one of the best and one of the few fragrances that this house actually has to offer. This is by Narciso Rodriguez and is simply called For Him. They also do have a musk version, which is kind of like a limited edition, collector's edition. I also like that one too. I've really been craving the original this year. I don't own the musk version, but I do have a few samples of it. This is fantastic. Some people compare this to the smell of a wet sidewalk. And as weird as that sounds, it actually does kind of have that feel to it. It's a very dry, kind of like a very moist but dry, almost paradoxical fragrance. It has violet leaf in it, so it does have that contemporary masculine quality. Really nice fragrance. Make sure you check it out. Number 9 on my list. Number 8 on my list is another staple. This was in last year's video. It's also going to be in this year's video because every time you know, winter comes around, this fragrance is just very evocative of that very dark, rich, and resinous and bold. This one is from the House of Lalique, one of their best offerings. This one is Encre Noir. I know they're coming out with, or they've already come out with, a sport version. I'm not sure how that one's going to smell, but I love this one. This is a mainstay in my collection. Very dark, rich, resinous. For me, it reminds me of mastic oil, also known as lentisque or something like that. But it reminds me of this resin that's used that comes from Greece and different parts of Greece. So this actually brings back a lot of memories for me. Really nice scent. Number 7 on my list is a newcomer to my collection. This was actually given to me by a very good friend of mine, my good friend Anita, so thank you very much. And I have been wearing this one a lot. This one is a great fragrance for the winter, and it's also very affordable, and you're not going to see too many people wearing this, which is something that I really like about this scent. This one is by a company called Latafa Perfumes, and this is called Ragba Wood Intense. So there is an original Ragba, which is very vanillic and ambery and sweet. This one kind of tones down the sweetness because it has some more woodsy nuances, as the name implies, but it also has a distinct leather note in there with some dried fruits, and it has that sweetness to it, but at the same time, the wearability is amped up in comparison to the original. Beautiful scent, really nice when I'm craving something that smells sophisticated but also sweet at the same time. So it kind of has the best of both worlds, if you will. So that's number six. Number five on my list is yet another one of my favorite fragrances. Last year, I also had one from this house. I had Thierry Mugler's Angel Men Pure Leather, also known as Le Parfums de Cuir, because that one bears a lot of similarities to the original, and I really like that one. This one smells a little bit different. It still has that ethyl maltol note, which is what gives it that caramel-like smell, but this one has a nuance of tobacco in it. Can't get enough of this one. This is Angel Men Pure Havane. So kind of like a cherry, tobacco. It almost has like a balmy quality to it too. Very smooth, creamy at times. Very nice, very well done from the house of Thierry Mugler. Once again, this is Angel Men Pure Havane. Fantastic scent. So let's get into the top five, guys. Thank you so much for sticking around. So these are my top five heaviest hitting fragrances this winter. Man, I have been putting these to a lot of excellent use, and I look forward to wearing them in the next couple of months or so because we are actually getting a blizzard soon. So I know these are going to do well. They're really going to be able to withstand the cold elements of the season. So getting into my number five fragrance. This one I think was number three or number two on my list last year. I think it was number two. It did jump back a little bit in this list this year because I got some newer acquisitions and, you know, my taste has changed from time to time. So this one is by Bulgari and it's called Bulgari Black. So this is my number five fragrance. Great composition by Anique Minardo. Very well done. This actually has kind of like a rubbery feel but with some vanilla in the background. So it kind of does for me what this fragrance does. It has that leathery, smooth, almost sophisticated feel, but at the same time it has a sweetness to it too. So when I want the best of both worlds, these are the fragrances that I reach for. Number four on my list is a great fragrance to wear all around. You can wear this casually, on a date, semi-formal, formal, incredibly versatile, and the smell is amazing. This is from the house of Yves Saint Laurent, and this one is called La Nuit de l'Homme, also translating to The Man of the Night. Beautiful cardamom scent, very sophisticated, spicy, elegant, just does really, really well in all occasions, very versatile, one of my favorites. My number three fragrance is another favorite of mine. It made my list last year, and it is going to make my list this year. It's from the house of Christian Dior. This is a fragrance that I love to wear on formal occasions because it has this green quality that almost carries this professionalism with it. This is the parfum version of Eau Sauvage by Christian Dior. Again, green quality, but it also has an incense-y quality to it too. It has a very bitter variety of myrrh that gives forth this almost elegance to it, but it almost carries this mysterious aura with it too. Really nice, very professional smelling. I love reaching for this one. I've attended a few weddings this year, and I have been reaching for this one a lot. Really does the job very well. Number two on my list is a fragrance that was once again released in 2014. I think this is a superb release from the house. I was kind of iffy on this when I heard about it because I know they already have another flanker to this fragrance, but when I smelled this one, I mean, it just validated just how awesome it is. This is from the house of Bulgari, and this one is called Man in Black. I know they have the original, they have like an intense or an extreme version, and now they have Man in Black. This one kind of bears some similarities to Spice Bomb by Victor and Rolf, which I absolutely love to smell. I love to wear in the fall. Kind of has that cinnamony, tobacco, spicy, peppery nuance with the pink pepper. This one also has pink pepper, I think black pepper, some resins in there, a sweet, ambery, vanilla dry down. Just really, really nice. Professional, sophisticated, dark, bold, a little aggressive, but it has that sweetness to it too, so it's nice and tame, beautiful scent. So these were my top nine. I have one more for you, but before I get to it, I want to share some honorable mentions with you guys. These are the fragrances that I love to wear, didn't quite make the list, even though one of them, two of them actually made my list last year. They kind of fell out of the list, but I've still been wearing them a lot. First one is Cocorico by Jean-Paul Gaultier. This is a really nice fig leaf and cocoa scent. When I'm craving something that's a little bit on the sweeter side, I will reach for this one. Also, Lolita Lempicka's Eau de Minuit. So this is very similar to the original, has the licorice, the star anise, except this one contains agarwood, also known as oud. So it has that very unusual woodsy nuance to it too. So if I want something a little bit darker, I reach for this one. And the other one that didn't quite make my list, but was also a great scent, Band, released in 2014, is Girl by Pharrell Williams in collaboration with Comme des Garçons. So this one is a very weird, unique, kind of like a cedarwood vetiver scent, except it's really hard for me to find a good occasion in which to wear it. So because of that, I couldn't really put it on the list, and I didn't find myself reaching for it as much as I would have liked to. Now, with that being said, my number one fragrance on this list is a mainstay in my collection. It's a fan favorite in the community. A lot of people reach for it. I love it. Every time I wear it, I get compliments on it. It was my fiance's 30th birthday. I wore it. Her father loved it. A few other people loved it. I actually passed around my decan. A bunch of people were trying it. Every time I wear this, I just get overwhelming amount of positive compliments and whatnot. I love this scent. Once again, from the house of Christian Dior, this is Dior Homme Intense. So this is a beautiful, fantastic composition. It smells similar to the original Dior Homme. It has that iris in there, but at the same time, it has a sweetness to it too. So it it has a sweetness, it has a playful nature to it, but it also has that very contemporary, youthful, unisex iris note to it that guys love. Women also identify with it because a lot of people say it smells like makeup, and it just does really well. All around, fantastic scent, mainstay in my collection. Very happy that it holds the number one spot in my collection. So there you have it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. These have been my top 10 favorite fragrances for the winter of 2014 going into 2015. And this has been the designer edition. So if you own or have tried any of these fragrances, please let me know what you think. Leave a comment down below. Also, please don't forget to rate and subscribe for future videos and frequent giveaways. So again, everyone, thank you so much for watching. This has been Steven with another video from Redolescence, and I will see you guys soon.